Thank you for the introduction. So good afternoon to everybody. So I've been working at ESRF since almost 20 years now, and I'm pretty sure you cannot imagine all I scanned in my life. I mean, for example, fossils, leg of mammoth, hair, cement. But today we will focus on pharma application. So I will try to show you what we can do. So the content of my talk will be the following. So first an introduction, so quick introduction about micro and nanotomography at ESRF. I will present the ID19 beamline where I'm working, so which is dedicated to imaging techniques. I will try to show you that it is a suitable instrument to study various microstructures. So one important advantage of the ESRF is the capability to go to high energy. So maybe for pharma it's not so evident, but so we have this specificity. I will present absorption and phase contrast imaging. So for low material, low absorption material, it's really important to have access to this phase contrast, because we show, for example, this morning already the video of the fly. So recorded at SLS by Raymond, so maybe we'll re-show it later. But you cannot obtain this 3D, this movie, without phase contrast imaging. I will present different examples in pharma domain about tablet structure, particle shape, porosity, coating, and dissolution, because also one part of my job is to develop the technical aspects, that is to use this high flux available with synchrotron and to have the possibility to make to add force, first a force dimension to the study and to have the possibility to perform in situ experiments and, for example, the evolution of your sample with time-resolved experiment. Then I will present some conclusion and perspectives. And one part which for me is really important is the idea that we are image providers, but also you have to extract 3D parameters from these volumes to find solutions to your different problems, and this is another story. So this knife was made of steel, so it's just to mention that we have the possibility to go through 6 centimeters of steel and image such heavy sample. So the principle of microtomography is really simple, and it's based on radiography. So you have an incoming beam on your sample, and you, with a 2D detector, you record the transmitted beam, and so you have access to the linear attenuation coefficient. From 2D to 3D, so at ESRF we have our own filtered back projection algorithm is really well known, but we have our own software and we try to incorporate new algorithm, new features like ring correction and so on in this ESRF developed program. So it's commonly 10 minutes per scan, so to acquire thousands of projections. We can go down 0.2 seconds on ID19, and it takes usually 3 minutes, so we have dedicated GPU cluster to obtain the 3D volume. So it's a technique where you generate a lot of terabytes, so you have to handle also all this data. So for micro and nanotomography at ESRF, so the specificities at ESRF say we have beamlines that are dedicated to a technique, but you can perform microtomography on several techniques, but mainly it's on the ID19 beamline. Then we have 2 microtomography additional setup on BM5 that are also accessible for industry. On the medical beamline, we have a very large field tomography setup. They can handle a beam as large as the human body with an animal facility. On ID15, so we have the tomography at high energy and ultra-fast tomography. On ID11, we have a diffraction contrast tomography, so to combine diffraction and tomography. On ID6 also, with other imaging techniques. And finally, after the at the end of our first upgrade period, we build a beamline dedicated to nano imaging and nano analysis. So they combine imaging and fluorescence. And they can go down to 25 nanometer on air on the ID16B end station, and down to 10 nanometer under vacuum on the ID16A part. So the specificity of synchrotron CT at ESRF, so that have been enlarged by so our phase one upgrade project, are the high energies, so up to 250 kiloelectron volt on ID19 for medium resolution, up to 80 for high resolution. You can have access to phase contrast imaging, so both holotomography and Paganin approach. I don't want to go too much into the details, but I will show you picture where this is really important. And just to mention that for in situ, so this algorithm allows us to obtain the phase contrast with only one single in distance, because you have access to the phase contrast by increasing the distance between the sample and the detector. So we have an high flux, so we can go to high resolution, high signal-to-noise ratio, short acquisition time, so the fastest is on ID15, with 50 milliseconds for a 3D image, and so we can perform in-situ experiments. With the high flux, we can also use monochromatic beam, and so perform quantitative analysis. So just a few words about phase contrast. So the idea is to have access to the real part and the imaginative part of your refractive index. And just by increasing the distance between the sample and the detector, you will still have the same absorption signal, or on low absorbing samples, no absorption signal. And just by increasing the distance, you will have access to the phase contrast. So it's a really old example, but I like it very much. It's an aluminium alloy, so made on aluminium and aluminium silicon. So if you do a reconstructed slice of this alloy in absorption, you obtain nothing except the inclusions you can have in this alloy. And just by increasing the distance, so here 60 centimeters between the sample and the detector, you have access to the two different phases. But with your eyes, you can segment easily this picture, but the gray level inside and outside are the same. So by performing the real holotomography, that is to record several scans at several distances, you can obtain this kind of contrast. And so if you plot in this absorption image or in this phase contrast, you can see that you can easily distinguish the two phases. And this corresponds to a change in density of about 2%. So if you want to know if we will be able to separate two phases, you have to check your density, the density of the two phases you want to separate. So on ID19, so really dedicated to microtomography, we have three dedicated instruments, two sample stages for big samples. I mentioned leg of mammoth. So up to 30 kilograms, up to 50 centimeters large with a big Z stroke. So we have one in our experimental hutch and one in another hutch just before, allowing longer propagation distance, because when you go higher in energy or with bigger pixel size, you have to go further. So this is really unique to have up to 13 meters as propagation distance. So on our medium resolution, it's let's say between 3 and 50 microns, and on high resolution, between 170 nanometers to 3 microns. We have also compatible sample environments to add a fourth dimension to the study. So it's an imaging technique under air. Sample is not in vacuum at all. So we have relatively space around the sample. And so space for sample environments. So we have a lot of demands. So for example, to heat the sample, so to heat the sample on air up to 8 to this temperature. We have an induction furnace with atmosphere control. So we developed a slip ring for fluids because also it was not possible to turn the synchrotron. So we are turning the sample. The X-rays and the source are fixed and you turn your sample. But as soon as you have wires, and so my dream is one day to have sample environments with Wi-Fi, but it's not always possible, especially for cold cell, for example. We have an hygrometry control device, tension compression stage, fatigue stage, hot traction, let's say all what our users could need, and we have at ESRF a sample environment group that would be happy to help you to develop such devices compatible with microtomography. And so we can really have the possibility of real in-situ experiments. So let's move to the different examples in pharma domain I selected for today. So I will speak about tablet structure, particle shape, porosity, coating, and dissolution. So here are first reconstructed slice of tablet. So you see that you have access to the coating and to the different particle shape inside your tablet. So these are in absorption mode, but also in phase contrast, you could reconstruct with the same data sets the two kinds of contrast, and you can learn much more from your sample. So you can see particle shape, also other applications. You see all the microstructure of your different particle shape. So what I mentioned, all one part of this example have been done in collaboration with Novitam that has been already cited this morning. It's a startup based in Grenoble that helps our customers to extract 3D parameters from the images. So in this case, the idea is to identify the different kind of particles, to be able to count them and to measure them, to have 3D, real 3D parameters, real 3D distribution, for example. They can also measure the porosity in this kind of particles. And for the coating, so you can have access to the coating of your different tablets or with no curing, 4 hours of curing. So this example have been done, let's say, ex situ. So the sample have been prepared well in advance, but we could imagine to follow this in real time on the beamline. This is an example on dissolution. So this was a proposal. It was not an industrial example. So it was at 30 micron pixel size, and the idea was to put some glass microspheres inside the tablets to follow with time the position of these glass beads and to study the dissolution. This is another example of dissolution. So to conclude, so it's just to mention that with synchrotron, our beamline are instruments in constant evolution. We try to really optimize the image quality. So we work on detectors, on scintillators. We always want to improve the image acquisition. We work on detectors. And so to reach our goal, that is to provide new imaging techniques with best possible image quality. So for CT, the aim of ESRF is to provide the best image quality, working on the acquisition and 3D reconstruction developments. For industries, experiments are mainly on ID19, but also other beamlines are accessible, like the new nanoimaging 2N stations. And for 3-parameter extraction, this is another story. So for image processing and under request, we propose collaboration to our clients with 3D data analysis specialists for face-to-face discussions, definition of real customer needs, adapted algorithm to specific case, and so on. And I thank you for your kind attention. Tack.